Talk to you about regulation aspects of European policies about blockchains, because as you know, there is no such a thing at the moment. And I think also for good reasons, because blockchains is something, is a very basic technology, but can be used for many different applications and in many different manners. It's not necessarily decentralized, it's not, so it really depends on the application. But apart from this, what I'm here to talk to you about is a specific example of a research initiative where we have envisioned the usage of blockchains to solve actually what we could call a regulatory problem. Let me be more specific. A couple of years ago, we were looking at the current status of the internet, all the problems that we can identify, all the things that we can improve through research actions, which normally concern the technological domain, so more bandwidth, more capacity, access, etc. But then we realized that the most important issues on the internet nowadays concern policy and regulatory aspects. One is the role of the platforms, so how to avoid the concentration of power in a few platforms worldwide, how to create a level playing field for new entrants, for new actors, in order to enjoy or to use the potential of big data also for social purposes other than economic ones, and of course how to define responsibilities. And then another big policy issue that we came across is how this big data aggregation can be done. And this is also very relevant for the digital single market policy. So for instance, how to define a clear legal framework for transactions, how to protect privacy and ownership of data provided by European citizens, how to ensure, in essence, a kind of digital sovereignty of EU citizens over their own data. So the culprit, the man responsible for this is identifiable very easy in the high asymmetry which is existing in data governance nowadays. And this results from the centralized architecture of the dominant data platforms. If you think of Facebook or Google, everybody contributes data to a single platform, which then makes available part of this data to individual users, but never the totality of it, which remains, which is exploited according to more or less clear commercial rules for commercial purposes, mostly. So this extremely centralized architecture results on one side in unparalleled, if you want, new public services from such companies, because there is a lot of good coming from these companies, of course. But on the other side, also in extraordinary revenues from these companies, in unprecedented risk for privacy leaks, for instance, or in an uncompetitive advantage and high barriers for new entrants, which, as a result, stifles innovation. So the reflection was, if the network architecture, this centralized network architecture, is the cause of this problem, then perhaps other than regulatory solutions, which are of course put in place, and other approaches, perhaps network architectures themselves can come to the rescue, so different network architectures, more decentralized, can be a solution to this centralization of data and power. So the vision that we try to define in this call is that of a distributed architecture where each piece of user-generated information remains under the full control of the user or of the thing which generated it. And this can be done on personal data spaces, which can be personal devices or micro clouds or other ways of storing data at local level, and is subject to on-demand aggregation by third parties through, for instance, simple or standardized contract licenses on the model of Creative Commons, if you want, so that any third party can then query the whole population, if you want, in simple manners, and then get the data they need for social, commercial, or other purposes, and on the basis of this, then pay a license, use it freely, or whatever else. So this is what we call a decentralized data governance. Then the next step is, can we do it? Can we build it with existing technologies? And actually the answer was yes. It's not something that can be done in 2 minutes or in 2 months, probably, but technologies are already there. On one side, you can think of peer-to-peer technologies, which have proven to be very robust and reliable, even though they have a very bad image, very bad reputation due to illegal usage, which has been done for this, but which is not necessarily attuned on the technology itself. Then the other basic technology is blockchains, blockchains or distributed ledgers in general, for the possibility to implement a decentralized certification and security of transactions, which in this case will be data transactions between users. And then, of course, there are issues of scalability which have to be solved, but which do not appear to be insurmountable. And then using technologies or approaches which have been developed, for treating open data or linked data. So ways to manage data in a way that takes into account the explicit permissions from the users, from the citizens who have generated the data. So, and all these, then this distributed data governance concept could be applied to clouds, but also to social networks, and perhaps even more importantly to Internet of Things, if you think of the number of sensors which could be connected to the Internet in the next years. So, and the ultimate goal then, once all this could be possible, which of course is just, it's a research idea, so take it for what it is, but it will be to create a decentralized innovation ecosystem. Something, if you want, alternative, even though similar in concept to an app store or to current economic models on the internet, which is open to new entrants and to new and to open innovation because of this lower entry barrier for new entrants to benefit from big data aggregation without having to knock at the door of big companies. And also due to this privacy by design model, which is implicit in this kind of architecture, and then open to new services, so allowing more SMEs, but also social enterprises, to develop new concepts for social innovation, and then I'm talking about collaborative public services, collaborative economy, sharing economy, collaborative making, open democracy, and so on. So what have been doing, we have been doing in this field? Well, we have launched a call for research projects, which was published 1 year ago and which closed just 1 month ago. Actually, we are now in the phase of selecting proposals. So I cannot tell much more than we have received 15 proposals, whereas we expect to be able to fund only one of them. So there was really a huge interest for such an emerging field and an emerging concept. And then on another side, we have an ongoing action on collective awareness platforms, which is more oriented at the development of pilots of new bottom-up innovation and social collaboration models, which could then benefit strongly from this kind of decentralized architecture.